This is Dr. Cynthia Furse from the University of Utah. Today we're going to be talking about Y and Delta transformations and the Wheatstone Bridge. The Y and Delta transformations are used to simplify some of our special circuit evaluations and designs, and the Wheatstone Bridge is a very powerful instrumentation tool. Y and Delta transformations are used for circuits that are neither series nor parallel. Take a look at these resistors here, and particularly R1 through R5. Are they in series? No. Are they in parallel? No. In fact, R3 is a bridge resistor between the two series arms, R1 and R4, and R2 and R5. So this is a bridge circuit. No two resistors have the same current, and no two resistors have the same voltage, so this circuit is neither series nor parallel. You can see the picture right here showing you where the Y and delta parts of the circuit are. A delta circuit is basically a triangle. R1, R2, and R3 form one delta. R4, R3, and R5 form a second delta. The delta part of the circuit is shown in red. The blue part of the circuit, R1, R3, and R4, is the Y part. You can see it's kind of shaped like a Y. These circuits are also called T or pi. You can kind of see the T right here, and you can see the pi right here as well. So those are Y and delta portions of this particular circuit. Your book has the development of the Y and delta transformations, but here in this table you can see those specific transformations. Basically, any time you have a Y circuit, that's shown right here, you can convert that into a delta circuit and vice versa. Table 2-5 has analysis of various equivalent circuits, including the Y and delta transformation. Refer to this table and, in fact, put it in your notes so that you have it available for the exam. The bridge network simplifications, or the Y-delta transformations, are often used in order to simplify bridge networks. This picture, for example, you can see right here, the blue part has been brought out and converted from a Y circuit to a delta circuit, and then we can lay it out in this arm right here, and you can see how the circuit is literally laid out. Here is another place where it could be very useful to do a bridge network simplification, where we might convert from a delta transformation to a Y transformation. The Wheatstone Bridge is a very important and often used bridge circuit. You can see how it's lined up right here with the R1, R2, R3, and Rx, which used to be R5. Notice that R3 is a variable resistor. The balance condition is when you adjust R3 until the current, as seen in an ammeter, is equal to zero, then the circuit is said to be balanced. If IA is equal to zero, then we know that V1 would equal V2. That would be the balanced condition. Basically, once we have the balanced condition, we can just tweak R3 until IA is equal to zero, and then we know what Rx is equal to. Rx right here is equal to R2 divided by R1 times R3, which we can also measure. If you look closely, you'll see that this circuit has two voltage dividers. One of them right here is between R1 and R3, so V1 is equal to V0 times R3 divided by R1 plus R3. That's right here. V2, which would be equal in this case, is a voltage divider between R2 and Rx, shown right here. So the voltage dividers were what were used to derive the Rx equation. A Wheatstone sensor is used to put something here that changes resistance with temperature, pressure, etc. Remember we talked about resistive sensors. You'd plug the resistive sensor in here, and then you would measure the output voltage. The output voltage is equal to the change in resistance divided by the resistance, that's the R5 resistance, times V0 divided by 4. Notice that's the case when all of these R's are otherwise equal. The thing that this does is it basically amplifies a very small change in resistance, so it can make a very sensitive sensor for resistive sensors. So that's how the Wheatstone Bridge is typically used. So today we've talked about how to identify Y and delta portions of a circuit. Remember, those are circuits that are neither in series nor parallel. We talked about how to do transformations between the Y and the delta. That is very often used in order to be able to analyze our circuits. It's a very powerful circuit analysis tool. And then the Wheatstone Bridge, which is an excellent instrumentation device to be able to emphasize a small change in resistance, typically seen from a resistive sensor. The picture on the front, in this case, is mountain goats from the Uinta Wilderness area in Utah.